this video we are going to check iFlicks 2, which is one of the good software for video file conversion and metadata addition on Mac. First of all, we are going to see how easy it is to add a video file, add a metadata, convert it and add it to iTunes from this software. After that, we will see some of the specific features for this software. I have one of the test file, which is around 183 MB. So what we will do is, we'll try to give it any name. So what I will do is, I will just give it a name of friends as .s01.e01. You can give it any random name, but if you have TV shows, it's always good to add the season number and episode number at the end of it, so that it will recognize it much better. Now, let's add that file by clicking on this plus to this software. And you can see, as soon as we have added the file, it has automatically fetched all the details based on the file name itself. It has recognized that it's a Friend TV show, season 1, episode 1. You click on that and here you can see all the information is available. The name of the episode, the descriptions, ratings, genre, and even it will recognize whether the video is SD, HD or 720p, and it will automatically fill this value. You are allowed to change it, whatever you change will remain, and it has filled all the other details out there. As soon as I will hit the start, it's automatically going to convert this video and add it to iTunes right away. And it will add in a correct manner. It will automatically start showing up in your TV shows in iTunes. So that's how easy it is to add and update the metadata. You can also update things here. Like suppose the name was not correct and it didn't recognize. So if I want to change it, like I have changed the show name, and if I do the refresh metadata, it's going to fetch another set of information based on the show and season number and episode number, and it is going to update all the information. So with that ease, you can almost, with these three fields, name, show and season number, you can control almost everything which will be fetched automatically. You can see that it has changed everything based on the information which we have just changed from the show name. You can change the show name to again anything, and the information will be changed again, and you will be able to update it. The good thing is, for the movies, you will get the movie name. If you are not getting that information, you can just select, go to IMDb, get the correct movie name, and just copy paste that movie name into the movie name here, and it will fetch everything automatically. Most of the time this software works pretty good, unless there are some site issues where it is not able to fetch the informations. But the conversion is also pretty fast. If you have the MKV file, those are having as good as having a MP4 files. Your AVI takes some time, but it doesn't take as much as other softwares take, because it try to create a different container and put those files in those containers rather than fully convert that file, and you retain the quality of your file with that conversion process. There are certain other things which comes with this software. There are some presets mode. What you can set: iTunes compatible, Universal, iPod, iPad, Apple TV 2, and normal HD. So you can select any of the presets. You can select optimize for web streaming. This is one of the temporary folder where you want your temporary work needs to be done. And this is your file name which is coming out from here. All of this, you can, if you want, you can change the file name also. But this actually comes from here. Now let's see some of the specific preferences for this software. There are few good settings which comes with this software. These are the general settings which we have just seen from the other window, but this is one of the good thing where we can set up a watch folder, where you can add any folder here, and automatically whatever video files you add to that folder will be picked up, converted, and added to iTunes, which is a very, very good thing. It runs in a background and does this makes your conversion job very easy. Then there are rules. These rules, if you are aware of the Mac Automator, these are more or less in with the same line. You can set the rules how it should treat on file load, what it should add, whether it should add the HD tags. There are some other specific fixes after metadata update, what you want to do after processing, what you want to do. So let me show you. I have set up my own rules. You can add rules, you can edit, and you can create new rules here if you want. So like I wanted my movies file name in a separate way and my TV shows in a separate way. So I've added two new rules here. I will show you what the rules are. So if you click on edit, you can see that all of the following are true. Video kind of is TV show, and you will get all of those things here. Okay, so you can set how you want to set a home video. For the home video, you can actually select your own wallpapers and other stuff, other descriptions and stuff. So what will happen is, as soon as you load your home video, it's automatically going to bring that image on as a artwork and other stuff what you can do. But right now, like for TV show, set file name to show season and episode number, and set name as episode number and name. I wanted this E and episode number in the name, reason being that I use DLNA streaming server and I wanted those to be sorted in the episode number. So I added this thing. But this particular rule setting is pretty good because it gives you a lot of control on what you can do with this software, and automatically you can get it converted. So that's all about iFlicks 2. If you have a lot of video files and you want them to convert and look good in your iTunes, I would highly recommend the software. This is not only for the movies and TV shows, but this can actually make your home videos look pretty good. So if you are creating a lot of home videos and want to have a decent collections in iTunes, you can actually create it with this software. Hope you would have liked the video. If you have liked it, hit the like button or share it on your social networks. You can subscribe to Make Web World for more Mac related updates and more reviews of Mac softwares to see how you can utilize your Mac better.